Hi, I'm Peter Gilmore, the executive chef at Kia Restaurant. This is my son, Joe. We thought we'd have some fun today with Australian eggs. Hopefully you've all done your mise en place, your preparation. Get your oven turned on, make sure that's warmed up and your bain-marie's in the oven. Select your container for your souffle. All you need for that really is just a little bit of melted butter. Just paint all the inside and the sides of this container. And this is important because you want your souffle not to stick to the edges. And then you're just gonna need a bit of plain flour as well. Just get a little bit of flour and sprinkle it into the mold. You just wanna shake it around. Give it a little tap on the bench and then move it all around the edges as well. And then we'll get it right up around the sides here as well, where you've put the butter around the sides, just so you get a light film of flour and butter. It just means that the souffle won't stick. Make sure it's all nice and finely dusted. So what we want to do is we want to make what we call a roux. So first of all, we just put some butter into this pot. Go and pop the butter on the heat. Once that butter is completely melted, we'll add the flour. And what you want to do is you want to cook it out for about a minute on the heat. Grab the whisk and I'll get you to grab that milk. Joe, I'm going to get you to pour a little bit of this milk in. Not too much, just a bit. And again, a little bit more. That's it. And it's important to leave it on the stove now and then get it hot again. And we'll just bring it over to the board here so you can see. First of all, we're going to add the goat cheese. And you just keep whisking while it's hot. Comté cheese or Gruyere. And that's just gonna go straight in. And we'll pop the salt and pepper in now as well. Okay, so that's our seasoning. It should look like melted cheese at this stage, nice and gooey, coming off the whisk. Okay, so just one at a time, we'll just add the egg yolk and we're gonna whisk really quickly while it's in there. Okay, and then one more, mate. Yep, all in, thank you. Thanks, Joe. So into here, all the egg whites for the souffle. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna leave the whisk in there. I'm gonna give you a little bit of egg white and you're gonna whisk it in. And probably looking at about a third of the egg whites. At this point, we're gonna leave the egg whites in this bowl. We're gonna pour this into this bowl all at once. You wanna fold the rest of the egg whites through this mixture, just carefully with the whisk, very lightly. That's about it, guys. I'm not gonna overwork that. Take your mold. And then we're gonna pour all of this mix straight in. Try and keep it in the middle as much as you can. We're gonna go straight over to the oven, which is preheated with the water bath in it. Pop it right into the middle of that water bath. It's at 180 on fan cooking. We're gonna set our timer for 35 minutes. Pop the butter into the saucepan, and I've already diced up the eschalots and the garlic, nice and fine. They go straight in. Pop that on the stove, wooden spoon. Let the butter melt. Just that nice sort of lightly sweated eschalots, garlic and butter. And then we're gonna add all of the cream at once now. And then we're gonna pop it back onto the stove and turn it up to full speed. Our cream has reduced, it's about 50% of the original volume of cream that went in there. While it's hot, we really need to add the cheese. You whisk and I'll add the cheese. Give it a really good mix up. And now I'm gonna add my salt and pepper and lemon zest at this stage too. With the cheese sauce, once that's made, we'll just pop it over to the side. So guys, this is our souffle here. This is gonna sit here for a little moment in the water bath. They will drop when they come out of the oven because these savory souffles aren't quite the same as sweet souffles. We're gonna reheat the cheese sauce and just get that nice and hot.
Keep mixing it?
Yeah, keep mixing it on the heat. So to go with the souffle, just wanna serve a nice little bit of salad on the side of your plate here. You know, like I say, it will drop a little. You need to just cut around with a spoon. We're gonna scoop out a lovely bit of that souffle. This is the amazing thing about, you know, what egg whites do. It's just this really light, beautiful, ethereal souffle. You're gonna pour a little bit of cheese sauce all over that souffle, mate. That looks good. Excellent. This is our souffle with Gruyere sauce and a beautiful little side salad.